Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Super Smash Bros. For Wii U Classic Mode. Last time we played through as Mii Sword Fighter. God, the menu's so sensitive in this version of the game. With Mii Sword Fighter, and this time, for the final Classic Mode run, we're gonna be going through as Mii Gunner, of course with the default special moves, so let's do this. And we're also using default Mii Gunner that I went ahead and made. Now, I've only beaten this on 6.5 with Mii Gunner, so we are definitely gonna crank this up to 9.0 like we did with the other Mii Fighters, just to see how we do. Alright, we got Rival Greninja up there, which does scare me a little bit because Greninja is pretty good, but I don't want to go to a free-for-all right now. I want to be able to get my my special moves explained and whatnot. Now, I want to mention as well, still a little bit sick when recording this episode, definitely better than I was when we did Mii Sword Fighter, but if I cough or sniffle at all, that is why. Alright, starting off, special moves. We have Charge Blast, which is essentially Samus's Charge Beam. Yep, it's basically the same. We have Flame Pillar, which is essentially PK Fire. Yep, there you go. We have Lunar Missile, which is the standard up special. I believe it actually meteors, if I'm not mistaken. And then we also have Echo Reflector, which is just Fox's Reflector, so Mii Gunner pulls from several different characters, but yeah. Honestly, in this game, Mii Gunner's the one that I use the least. They just don't feel quite as good or as fleshed out as the other two. I mean, they're by no means like the worst character in the game, but I'm fairly certain... Well, actually, maybe they are. I don't know. I'm fairly certain they don't get put on tier lists. At least in this game, purely because Mii Fighters are so... they're so different in Wii U than they are in Ultimate. Also, there's two Boss Galagas. Thank you, Boss Galaga. Please come and help me out down here, my friend. Thank you. Go ahead and charge this up just in case Wii Fit Trainer breaks out, which she did not. Okay. So starting off playing Sonic Heroes, not complaining about that. Alright, there we go. Also want to briefly or quickly apologize that I didn't get this video out yesterday and I instead put out an office tour. That was simply for the fact that, I was so sick. Like, I couldn't do it. I did not feel like I could record a gaming video. So I was like, let's do something a little more casual than that. I mean, this is still pretty casual, but still. Also, Giant Duck Hunt. Okay. Ooh, maximum. I picked Yoshi's Island because it's semi-walk-off, but then Giant Duck Hunt showed up, and oh, look at this dude! Look at this big boy! I don't know what I just got hit by, but okay. God, that could have killed me. We could have died that soon to Game & Watch. Game & Watch. That was just my messed up sinuses not letting me say words, and we're already dead! Okay. Maybe we should let Game & Watch deal with Duck Hunt over there. Okay, 35. I don't like this fight. This was fine until the Giant Duck Hunt showed up. That scares me a whole bunch. I'm seriously just considering letting Game & Watch deal with it. And just running away. I mean, Game & Watch has been doing not a terrible job so far, so maybe that's gonna work out. If we can get the Dragoon, that could come in handy! Where are we? We're dead? What? Okay, that was ridiculous. You know, I said it when we came back to Classic Mode in Wii U, and I'll say it again. Classic Mode in Wii U was trash. I didn't really say it much, when we were doing the initial playthroughs, you know, the main 55 characters, but, yeah, Classic Mode in this game's kinda trash. It's very much luck-based. Now, don't get me wrong, Classic Mode in all the other games can be luck-based. Depending on which characters you fight, depending on which items spawn, we're dead again. But, stuff like this, just having Giant Duck Hunt appear and just decimate everything because they're giants, and they're obviously going to decimate everything. And, I mean, you saw that fight. Yeah, it's 9.0, but we should not have died like that. That should not have gone down how it did. But the game hates us. Or it's just because we're Mii Gunner, but I don't really know. Okay, that was mine, Game & Watch, and that was just rude. I'm gonna, like, come away from the walk-off portion of the stage, because we could die immediately if we stay over there. I know that's how I was initially planning on winning, but... Still. Did we get that? We did. Okay, send him up. Or don't. God, this giant freaking dog is... Can you just go? Can you go, please? Ugh. I didn't mean to throw... Okay, there we go. Back it. No, I didn't do it. There we go. That was crazy. And again, that was luck. If we hadn't gotten the screw attack, we probably would have been, well, screwed. Okay, so we're already down to 8.5 with me, Gunner. I kind of expected not to do great in this one, but I didn't think we'd already be down to 8.5 on the second fight. That was kind of crazy. And just because you just caused us so much trouble, I'm going to bring in Duck Hunt. There we go. Fox and Wario on a team, and then Greninja and Ness. And we're on Midgar. Okay, Greninja, I'm definitely going to try to focus Greninja, because he's Greninja, and he's our rival. So, we should probably do that. Where are we? Okay, we're right there. Okay, don't double team me right off the bat, please, green team. Duck Hunt, you are not doing a very good job, like, at all. I gotta remember, though, it's not those four against us two, it's two on two on two. So I should keep that in mind. And I'm used to Ultimate mechanics, and I'm over here trying to do that. I played Ultimate since recording the Mii Sword Fighter video, so I'm still kind of in the Ultimate mindset right now. And I'm sorry that I've done so many comparisons to Ultimate during these last three episodes, but you gotta understand, it's been a long time since I touched Wii U, and we kind of just came back for this for these three episodes after I've played Ultimate for so long. So, that's kind of why I've been comparing it so much, because that's the only Smash I've been doing as of late. Well, I've been playing, been doing is means something else. Also, Greninja's already gone, apparently. So, I am not complaining about that. You are not getting me, Ness. That's not happening. Good job, Duck Hunt, right there. Alright. I think Duck Hunt was the right choice to bring in. Definitely not complaining about the performance in that match. Round 3 has been cleared. Okay. Moving on, what are we dealing with? Get out of here, Greninja. Okay, we got a 1v1 with Yoshi down there. Okay! I guess that's not where we're going. I guess I didn't pay attention to where my character was in relation to those, but still. He could have put me over there. I wanted to go fight 1v1 with Yoshi, not go to Mario Circuit Brawl with 7 other people. Which, actually, this stage got renamed to Figure 8 Circuit in Ultimate, so that's a nice little detail if you care about that. Now, this is a walk-off, so it scares me a little bit, but at the same time, it could definitely come in handy for it. That definitely looked like Meta Knight did his glide from Brawl, and that scared me. This is a Brawl stage, you don't need those Brawl moves. Get out of here, Bowser. That is a... Why is that such a big dude? Oh, I guess... Oh, he's a custom Duck Hunt, isn't he? I guess that's one of his custom moves. Okay. That makes more sense. And we have died. Okay. We have died. Go away, Bowser Jr. Go away. And he's gone. Okay. Well, I said that a little preemptively, but I figured he was gonna die. You have a bullet, and I don't like that. I gotta remember we have a reflector. I keep forgetting that. I mean, there's certain moves with these Mii fighters at least the default ones, that I just don't use, and that's one of them. That is one of them. Come here, Game & Watch. I'm gonna just pew you a little bit, and never mind. Oh, he almost got us with that forward smash, but we are the victor. We are indeed the victor. Okay, round 4 clear. Alright, I kinda wish we'd gone down to that 1v1, honestly. We've had a lot of fights where there's just been a lot of opponents. Team battle? Choose a single teammate. Let's go ahead and bring in Greninja, just because he was our rival. And I feel like giving him another shot. Roy and Robin, Captain Falcon and DDD, and it's another walk-off stage. Okay. I like how Mii Gunner's name just got changed to me. It's a little odd, but okay. Did I not name this Mii Gunner? Did I name it me? I'm fairly certain I named it Gunner. How is Greninja gone already? That is some bullcrap. I didn't see what happened to him, but he should not have got launched like that. Okay. Okay, I wanted that Pokeball. God damn it. Victini could technically affect a bunch of people, but it didn't. We're at 69. Why did Greninja die so soon? I didn't see what happened to him. And don't worry, you don't need to comment and tell me what happened. I can look back in editing and see what happened. And we lived. Bombs. Okay. Wait, they're on the same team. They are on the same team. I don't like this. I don't like this one bit. Ooh, got Robin at the tip of that. And I'm fairly certain that also got rid of the Pokeball. Come here, Roy. Come here. Nope, wrong way. Did I? Okay, I picked it back up. Get out of here! God, there's like no impact on these hits. That's so strange. so many things about this game that I thought were like fantastic. I'm looking back now, I have to go into the next game, and it's like, wow, they really missed a lot of good points. They missed out on a lot. Like, I didn't know that was gonna kill. I didn't feel like it was gonna kill, even though I was right at the edge of the stage. Maybe that's just me. That could just be me, I don't know. But... I don't know, I'm gonna try to stop comparing to Ultimate now, because that's all I've been doing. But you guys gotta admit, if you've played Ultimate, it's the best Smash game. You gotta admit it's the best Smash game, right? Because it is. It's the best Smash game. You know, if you don't think that, you probably like Melee. But, nothing against Melee fans, by the way. I'm just saying, mechanically, and in terms of roster, and in terms of just all kinds of things, Ultimate is by far the most superior Smash game. I mean, that's how it was designed, so. Also, why are some of these Miis going down really easy, and then some of them just aren't dying? What's the move? Okay, I guess dash attack's the move that's getting all the kills right here. Let's see. Oh no, it's my old Mii right there. Speaking of my old Mii, the one with the long hair, there was an episode of Mario Kart Worldwide that I recorded recently. I don't believe it's out yet. And I knew that was gonna kill us, but luckily timer and only 5 opponents left. It's not out yet, but someone showed up with my old Mii, or with a Mii that looked very similar to mine, in one of those episodes that I recorded. And it said that they were from the UK, and the Mii's name was Thomas. Now, I named my Mii Ash, because it's my nickname, but... yeah. It scared me. I was like, who is this? Why is it saying they're from the UK? Why do they look just like my old Mii? I was a little scared, I'm not gonna lie. I'm not sure which episode that was, but it won't be out for a while, so... you'll see whenever that does come out. Alright, here we go. 8.5, Master Hand and Crazy Hand. We definitely could have gotten to this on 9.0. Because Mii Gunner actually turned out to be a little better than I remember. But that giant duck hunt just had to screw us up. Just had to screw us up in that one fight. Alright, let's do this. And no, the Mii is definitely called Gunner. Alright then. Come here, Master Hand. Okay. I'm guessing up air might be pretty good here. Can I reflect these? It cannot reflect those. All right, and there I go thinking that directional air dodge is a thing again. It is not. You've just got to be doing the direction before you air dodge. And again, with the bad timing on these, I really got to get these Master Hands down. Actually, no, I don't. This is the last time we're fighting Master Hand or Crazy Hand in Wii U, because this is the last classic mode running Wii U. So of course, oh my God, he comes at the screen way faster than I remember. Again. Ultimate on the brain. See, he would have clicked sooner in Ultimate, I'm fairly certain. And that's what's messing with me, and the combo, and if I don't tech this, we are dead. We don't get sent down, never mind. And then he grabbed his, oh my God. Mii gonna break out. Please just kill. Just kill, there we go. That's a move that didn't get brought back in Ultimate, the weird card thing. God. This is not a good run of the hands, good lord. Can we do this, Mii Gunner? Can we do this without you just dying horribly and having to redo it? Okay, there we go. I keep getting that one, that move, and then the one where he brings out the weird, like, yellow-orange hands out. Like, I get that mixed up, and I'm just gonna stay up here for a second. Yeah, don't mind me. The shield. Oh my God, it broke the shield, God damn it. Yeah, this one. I get this one and the weird shockwave move mixed up for some reason. Please break out of there, Mii Gunner. We are not beating this on 8.5. Okay, there we go. Yeah, we're definitely not going to do this on 8.5. I'm tempted to just let Mii Gunner die right now, but I'm going to see how far we can get. I just kind of don't want the embarrassment of dying again, and I don't know how we didn't get sucked into his head right there, but okay. Alright, 32%. That's not fantastic. I will say that much. That is not fantastic in the slightest. And we're not Mii Sword Fighter, so we can't just counter every move from Beast, which ultimately did kind of work out better. I'm not gonna lie, just getting the counter on everything right here was perfect in the last episode. Come on. Nope, and a forward smash for you. Do you think? Nope. Oh, I thought I rolled. Well, I did. Okay, I'm getting the timing wrong horribly right here. Like, terribly badly. And I should have stayed on the ledge. And I don't know how I didn't manage to shield that, but okay. Smash for Wii U is not a great game. It's an okay game. It's pretty good. It was good for the time. It was good for what it is. But, going back to it now, Smash Wii U is not that great, is it? I mean, it's... we're dead. There it is. It's okay. It is okay. But it's not that great. It feels way too floaty. Is that just me? You know what? Maybe I was just a little salty. I might have just been a little salty when I said that. Smash Wii U is good. It is a good Smash game. Do not get me wrong. It is a good Smash game. It is just not the best Smash game. And it's not as good as it was when it was the most recent one. I can say that much. But here on 8.0, managed to get up to Master Beast without dying yet, which is pretty nice. But what's not nice is that I keep taking all these freaking hits from Beastie over here, which I'd like to avoid doing. Beastie, you are moving way too fast, and your moves are coming out, like, way too close to each other. I don't like that. Please refrain from continuing to do that. That'd be great. Okay, there we go. 150%. Good lord. Let's do this. So, I remembered, I think it was either in the Mii Brawler or the Mii Sword Fighter episode, I talked about eventually wanting to go back and get the 9.0 with every character in this mode, and that's probably something I will do at some point. I'll make like a stream series out of it or something, but thinking about it now, like at the time I was like, maybe that's not worth it because that would take forever because this classic mode is very much based on luck. I totally forgot that you can use equipment. Like, you can equip your characters with a bunch of stupid buffs. And that's how I could get 9.0 with all of these characters. I could just make all of my characters super defensive, like unable to be moved, and like have crazy high attack power or something like that. Or, I don't know, you can do stuff like that using the equipment in this game. Or I could just start every match with a home run bat and stuff like that. And then I could actually make this considerably easier on myself. I don't know why I forgot about equipment. Probably because in Ultimate it doesn't get used. Or it, actually no, it doesn't exist in Ultimate, never mind. But that's definitely something I could do to get the 9.0 with every character. It doesn't matter about what score I get, just as long as I hit 9.0. Okay, I'm a little more reinvigorated to potentially do that now. But not anytime soon. Don't get me wrong, I'm not doing that anytime soon. But going into Master Fortress with two stocks, I forgot that that reflects. I forgot that that reflects. Okay, get rid of you. That throw was very wimpy, me Gunner. That really didn't do anything. Oh my god, you're still alive. Okay, whatever, we'll just kill this first. Just take down the core, I don't care if you shoot me, because we're at 180, and... I mean, there's a heart container right there, so... I will deal with it. Alright, you know, I think I will heal now, though, because we've got the two stocks, yes, but... we might as well stay alive as long as possible, and I mean, that heart container will fully heal us, so, yeah, I think 180 is a pretty good place to do that at. Okay, please, will you finish off this freaking plant? There we go. Alright, let's do this. This is arguably the best run we've had so far. I mean, I'm fairly certain we got knocked down to 8.0 with me Sword Fighter as well. But I think we're still doing better in terms of, like, how many stocks we have going into Master Fortress with me Gunner than we did with me Sword Fighter. Might just be me, but I don't remember. It's been a couple days. It has been a couple of days. Alright, 1% damage going into the second phase of Master Fortress. Two stocks. That's the wrong move, but me, Gunner, I think you might be okay if you stop shooting these guys who can reflect things from you. Don't do that. I'm talking to myself right there, because I keep doing these moves. And could you launch? There we go. Alright, let's get this. Also, in terms of getting 9.0 with all of the fighters, I don't have to do it with each of the Mii fighters. Yeah, it would be nice, but... I mean, unless the game, like, explicitly says, hey, you didn't get 9.0. I'm fairly certain for the Miis, because they're grouped together. Oh my god, there we go. Because they're grouped together, it says, like, a collective 9.0 for the Miis, because we got that with Mii Brawler. But also, thinking about it, when you head in and you select the intensity, I do believe it shows you, which intensity you last completed it on with that character. And it actually does separate the Miis at that point, so maybe I do need to do 9.0 with the individual Miis. But at the same time, with equipment, it really shouldn't be too much of a problem. I'm actually gonna look into that, after we finish this run, because I'm curious now. I'm curious if it does, in fact, separate the Miis scores. Because I know on the character select it says 9.0, because it said that when we selected Mii Gunner, but... just for my own peace of mind, I didn't mean to fall. just my own peace of mind, I'm gonna go ahead and check that after this run. And come on, finish him off. Damn it. Me gonna why. I love that you can just kind of move along that beam. And one more hit is all it took, apparently. One more hit is all it took. Alright, me gunner. Let's get these taunts out of the way. The up taunt. Side taunt. And down taunt. Pretty interesting. I'll give them that. I mean, they feel kind of Samus-y, but... I mean, me gunner is pretty Samus-y, so that doesn't really bother me too much. Alright, and a 1-2. And a 1-2. Alright, that's not really doing much, is it? That didn't do it either. Why is this taking forever to go down? Alright, one more hit should do this. Or not? One more? You took your sweet time taking him down there, me gunna. Jeez, but we lost a lot of stuff, but 8.0, not horrible for me gunna. Alright, here we go, the final credits game for Smash Wii U's Classic Mode, and it's just the same freaking image again, because of course it is, but, let's do this, let's see if we can get this 100%. I'm a little disappointed that I missed out on hitting Masahiro Sakurai's name at the top, but, oh well! Oh well. Alright, so I kinda wanna bring up a little comment question for this episode, because it is the final episode of Classic Mode for Wii U, and, I don't really have one. I don't really have one relating to the game. I guess we'll just make it simple. In Wii U, specifically in Smash for Wii U, not in Smash Ultimate, in Smash for Wii U, what is your favorite Mii Fighter class? Mine is still Brawler. It always has been Brawler, purely because they feel the most well-rounded and most fleshed out of the Mii Fighters. Maybe that's just me, I really don't know. It could be. It always could just be me. Sorry, I am out of breath for some reason, and I'm dead! Okay. Well, I can tell you exactly why I'm out of breath. I got a freaking cold still, so it's making breathing just a handy-dandy little bit difficult. And I don't know why I said handy-dandy, because it's really not handy-dandy. It's actually really annoying, and it's the reason I haven't recorded much over the past few days. Alright, let's go ahead and grab this mushroom right here. But yeah, let me know in the comment section below, specifically in Smash for Wii U, your favorite class of Mii Fighter. And if you have any Mii Fighters that you use, that you enjoy, or designs that you've made, or anything like that, feel free to talk about them in the comment section, because as you've probably seen from my menu, I have Eric, but he was sent to me by my friend Augusto. I don't actually remember the story behind Eric, but... I've got various different versions of him, and there we go. I think I also have Natilda, which is like a female version of Brazilian Nut, which is Augusto, the guy who sent me Eric. And then I have Tammy, which is like a female version of me. But there we go, another 100% completion.
Congratulations!
But we are not quite done yet. We didn't get the chance to show off Mii Gunner's final smash. In fact, the only Mii Fighter that we've gotten to show it off for was Mii Sword Fighter. So we are going to head into training. We are going to select Mii Gunner once again. Right over here. Mii! And we are going to take a look at that final smash. Let's just go Omega Random. Colosseum, okay. Colosseum. I don't care about Yoshi's egg roll. Alright, Smash Ball, gimme that. This is Full Blast. You can angle it up and down, and that's about it. I mean, I'll be honest, I don't think its range is fantastic. Hold on, let me jump way... Okay, face inward, me gunner. Let me jump way out here and see how much range this thing gets. Okay, so it... Never mind, it covers the entire stage, but you get my point. It only did 41 to Jigglypuff from center stage and didn't kill, so... I think you see my point. It's not fantastic, but it's not the worst Final Smash in the world. Alright, and then of course we need to go look at Me Gunner's trophy that we just got from completing Classic Mode. So, let's go ahead and do that. Let's go Vault Trophies Gallery! By series, Smash Bros, and it should be right down here, Me Gunner. A Me sporting a blaster arm. This fighter is a great choice for those who prefer to fight the battle from a distance. The Me Gunner has a lot of special projectile moves available, so pick your favorites and use them when needed. Don't forget about standard and smash attacks! What a terrible description. Here's in Smash Wii U, of course, and the trophy box. I'm guessing it's called Gunner. It is called Gunner. It features... Me Gunner! Me Gunner! Full blast! And then a boomerang and a ball, which are not guns. But okay. Whatever you say. And before we end off the episode, like I mentioned, I want to go in and I want to just check the 9.0 thing. Because if we hover over these characters, you'll see, you know, 8.0, 7.5. 9.0 with the Miis. But if we select Mii Sword Fighter, it still says 9.0. But then if we hit start, it shows 8. So that is something that I'm going to want to crank up to 9. So I will actually have to do it with the Miis eventually when I get around to that. But for now, folks, that is actually going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Super Smash Bros. For Wii U Classic Mode and for this series until Ultimate is finished. If you haven't caught my drift by now, once Ultimate is done, we are actually jumping back into Smash Wii U because we never did All-Star Mode. So we are going to be doing that. And events. We'll eventually get to the events. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like. And of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for tomorrow when we'll be back on Smash Ultimate, and I'll see you guys then.